Hey everyone, Holden here with Gold Plating Services. Today we're going to be talking about our 24K Brush Gold solution for brush plating. Do not confuse it with our 24K Bright Gold solution, which is for bath plating. But if you are bath plating and looking for information on the 24K Bright Gold solution, you can watch this video right here and it will cover everything you need to know about that solution. So this video is going to be about our hard 24K Brush Gold solution. So we're going to introduce what you need to know before you begin plating, discussing the attributes of brush gold, describe how to use the brush gold in the electroplating process, and offer tips and tricks to help your plating process go as smoothly as possible. What to know before you begin? Because gold is a dense metal, it produces a plate that is durable but quite thin compared to other metals. This thinness means that it will reflect the exact condition as the base metal. Some people assume that gold plating functions similarly to paint. While gold plating will change the color of your item, it will not cover up the flaws or change the finish of the piece like paint is capable of doing. Gold plate will reflect the same luster, brightness, and finish of the metal that it is being plated onto. Prep work is crucial for gold plating, and it's very important to thoroughly clean and polish your items before you begin the plating process. It is also important to determine whether or not you will need to fill in scratches or flaws with nickel or copper, or if you will need a diffusion barrier before you apply your gold. Just make sure that your item looks exactly how you want it to look before beginning the plating process. Depending on how much gold is in your sleeve or tip, it takes about 10 to 15 seconds of gold plating per square inch for your item to become opaque. This means that the item is totally covered in gold and the color of the base metal can no longer be seen. Once your item becomes opaque, even though the gold layer continues to build up as you plate, you will no longer be able to visually witness this happen. There are certain ways to determine the gold thickness, and the two most common being by carefully and precisely weighing your items before plating, or by using an XRF machine. You can also get a good estimate of your gold thickness by determining the surface area of your items and keeping track of how much solution you are using on those items. We will discuss this further in the tips and tricks section of the video. We often hear the question, how many pieces can I plate with your gold? This is difficult to answer because how long a bottle will last is based on several different factors. It could be the surface area of your items you are plating, the amount of gold you want plated onto your items, how much waste will occur in your plating process, and your skill level. However, this chart can give you a good basic idea of how much surface area you can plate at a specific thickness per gram of gold. Another question that is asked is how long should my plating last on a particular item? This is also difficult to answer because it's based on how thick the gold is plated and the conditions of use. For example, a trophy with a decorative plate could last a lifetime if it is simply on display and not handled. Or a ring with 2 microns of gold could only last 2 years if it is worn all the time, experiences friction against your skin and other materials, and if it comes into contact with soap, lotions, swimming pools, etc. If you are new to gold plating, expect to experience a learning curve as you familiarize yourself with our products and with the items you are working with. We recommend always practicing on sample pieces that are made of the same material as your project. Brush plating produces a deposit that is not as consistent across the surface as bath plating. The deposit is affected by voltage, current, how much gold is in the sleeve, the speed and pattern of movement across the surface, and the type of area and surface it is applied to. When planning a project, account for solution loss. This occurs through solution that drips from the item and the handle, as well as unintentional overdeposits in certain areas. This will be discussed further in the tips and tricks section of the video. If you are unsure how to approach a project, please reach out via email, phone, or our Gold Plating Services form on Facebook. If you do run into any issues during your plating, do not move on with the process. You need to stop and troubleshoot and reach out for help if needed. If you move on, the problem may get worse and could be more time-consuming and difficult to correct. We provide tech support to our customers because we want to see you succeed. Attributes of brush gold. Our 24K brush gold solution is for brush plating processes only. Our bright gold solution is used for bath plating. Brush gold is much more concentrated and contains more gold content per fluid ounce. Sometimes a customer needing brush gold accidentally orders bright gold instead, and if this happens, you can catch the error before opening the bottle and you can return the solution and order a replacement. However, if you have opened the bottle or even begun plating with it, it can still be used for brush plating, although it's not ideal. The gold will deposit much slower and you will need to dip the brush more frequently because the bright gold solution is not as concentrated as the brush gold. It is important to note that our 24K brush gold is fabricated to be ready to use. There is nothing that needs to be added to it, and dilution of the solution prior to use will negatively affect its function. Our brush gold solutions come in various sizes, and the larger the quantity you order, up to 1 liter, the less you pay per gram of gold. Also, the sizes available on our website are the options most commonly used by our customers. But we do offer a bulk discount if you're needing a larger volume than what is available online. Please contact us directly. While our bright gold solution comes in 24K, 18K, and 14K options, our brush gold is only available in 24K. Brush gold comes in a liquid or a gel form. The gel is often preferred when customers are plating onto vertical surfaces. You can also purchase gold thickener, which is a fine powder that can be added to your liquid solution to turn it into a gel, creating the consistency that you prefer. Gold thickener does not alter the appearance of the gold deposit or its function of the solution in any way. The only thing to be aware of is that the brush gold in gel form is more sensitive to cold temperatures and can be damaged if it freezes. It can also become damaged if it dries out. However, dried gold gel can often be revived by adding a few drops of distilled water at a time and mixing it until it reaches the consistency you prefer. Brush gold is hard gold. It contains additives that produce that hardness, which is why it has a purity of 99.7% as compared to our 24K pure brush gold, which is soft and has a purity of 99.9%. Brush gold is most commonly used when application by hand is necessary for decorative plating for items such as awards, costume jewelry, plaques, hardware, and artwork. It is also used in industries such as the fine jewelry, music, automotive, and firearm industries that require a hard gold plate. There are other industries brush gold can be used for as well, although there are some applications that can't tolerate the components of the hardeners or that need a soft gold, in which case our pure brush gold solution is the best option. How to use brush gold. Brush gold is usually the final setup in most brush plating processes. We recommend using a stainless steel bit while plating. You can also use brush gold at room temperature, and it works best at a voltage of 2.5 to 3 during plating. Note that once you start plating, the voltage drops, so often the starting voltage is set to about 4 so that it will drop to the appropriate range as plating begins. If your voltage is too high, you might notice a darker gold deposit that has a burned or bronzy look to it, and this is easily removed by lightly polishing the item with a polishing cloth or with a paste made out of baking soda and water. Ensure your sleeve or tip is fully saturated prior to use. Apply the gold by lightly rubbing the sleeve over the surface in small circular motions with light pressure. Dip the sleeve into the solution often to keep new solution on the surface. When applying the gold, don't stop moving the sleeve and don't let it rest in one spot. This can cause that burned, dull, dark deposit. It is easy to fix, but it can be time consuming. When the gold becomes opaque, it is approximately 3 micro inches thick. After that point, it is impossible to determine the thickness visually. To ensure the most uniform thickness of around 10 to 12 micro inches, which would be a decorative thickness, you should plate about 3 to 4 times as long as it took for the original opaque deposit to happen. And make sure to only use distilled water for the rinse water. Tips and tricks for brush gold. Here we're going to talk about and determine how much gold solution to use for a particular project. First, calculate your surface area, then decide how thick you want the gold plate to be, then account for solution loss due to waste or over-depositing, and then determine how much gold you will need to use up within that area to achieve a particular thickness. For example, we need to first calculate the surface area, and for this item, it is 6 inches by 10 inches. By multiplying the length by the width, it has a surface area of 60 square inches. Second, we will decide how thick of a gold plate we will want. I'd like to have this be plated with 1 micron of gold. The third step is now accounting for solution loss. I'm going to add about 1/3 of my surface area to my total amount to account for the solution loss that will either be wasted or unintentionally over-deposited in certain areas. So 1/3 of 60 squared inches is 20 squared inches. So I'm going to determine that the amount of gold used based on the surface area of 80 squared inches. The fourth step is determining how much gold to use. Looking at our chart, it will take 1 gram of gold to plate 80 square inches to a thickness of 1 micron. I have a bottle of brush gold here that contains 1 gram of gold in it. Because our actual surface area is 60 squared inches, we could potentially plate 1 micron on this item by using up only 3/4 of this bottle. But remember, we are accounting for loss that will occur during our plating process, so I will use up all of the solution in this bottle to plate this surface with 1 micron of gold. If I wanted to plate a jewelry grade thickness on this item, I would use up half of this bottle. And if I wanted to plate a decorative thickness on this item, I would use up 1/4 of this bottle. Now we're going to talk about plating large surface areas with brush gold. We are including some of the basic tips in this video for brush plating large surface areas, but before tackling too large of a piece, we recommend checking out our other videos on this topic or contacting us directly. Brush plating large surface areas require professional level technique and careful attention to masking, proper rinsing, and proper transitions. This is especially important to follow these techniques when plating larger items because when you are plating in sections, the transition areas can easily be overactivated. However, this can be easily avoided with proper technique. Feel free to reach out to us to discuss specific techniques for your project before you begin. For large areas like rims, for example, we recommend working in sections initially. This will ensure that each section remains wet out between each pre-treatment and plating step until it is covered with a gold flash. A gold flash is a very thin, quick deposit of gold. If a section dries out before the steps are complete, then you will need to start over from the first step in that section. You can check out our video, Gold Plating a Hubcap in 24K Gold, for a good visual of this. Once the entire base of metal is plated in a gold flash, then you will no longer need to worry about pre-treatments and wetting out. You can just keep applying gold on top of the gold until you get the thickness that you want. Remember that once the gold plate is opaque, meaning the base metal underneath is no longer visible, you will not be able to see the gold depositing. You may want to occasionally test the solution you are working with in an area where you can see if it's still depositing. This will help prevent you from wasting time trying to plate with a solution that is already used up. With use, the gold gel solution becomes more runny and the purple color fades out. This is a sign that the gold is depleting and you will want to re-dip. This can also occur when plating smaller items too, but is likely more noticeable when plating large surface areas. It is normal for the color of your gold plate to slightly change as the plating cures. Fresh gold plating usually appears a little lighter than cured gold, and this curing process occurs within 24 hours of plating. However, in the case of the rims we just mentioned, when you apply more gold to the top of the gold flash, the color may actually darken initially and almost look like it's burning. But don't worry, the fresh gold plate will lighten as it cures. All right, that was a lot of information, and we hope this video has helped you understand a little bit more about our brush gold solution. Remember, you can contact us by phone or email if you have additional questions, but also we can help troubleshoot and resolve any issues you are having. Thank you so much for watching, and we hope to see you in the next video.